Johnny, thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you, Shannon.
As a marketing guru in this space, you have your finger on the pulse constantly. So when it comes to marketing trends with advisors right now, what are you seeing? What are you hearing?
Yeah, so there are two marketing trends that I want to talk about. First off is voice. And most people, when they hear that word, they think about brand voice and what you should be doing from communications. Obviously, that's important. But what I think about is voice search. And advisors should be thinking about creating content to navigate this kind of new world on how people are finding them. So there's a couple tips on just really structuring your content so it's easy to be found by search engines. When you think about voice, people usually search by asking a question. Building your content to speak to and structure to question based queries is pretty important. And then also, marketing automation. So I feel like advisors have probably heard this word a lot, automation. They hear it from the fintech aisles, and they need to be thinking about how to automate their communication on a mass scale with people and just reach more people, but still do it in a personalized, really authentic way, and taking advantage of the ability to use modern technologies to talk to a lot of people at once, but still do it in a way that's personal. Something all advisors need to understand how to incorporate into what they're doing from a communication standpoint.
And what technology are you seeing that's helping enable that automation process for them?
There's a lot of different marketing automation tools that firms can use. Actually, 20 over 10 has a new one they're releasing called Lead Pilot at the T3 conference in San Diego. So that I think is a cool one because it's custom built to advisors. You've also got things like HubSpot, which is industry agnostic, but which is a great tool. And what I think is interesting about client communication is you see a lot of the advisor tech companies getting into that area a little bit. Like you've got Orion Advisor Solutions, which they have different ways for advisors to automate communications. They can send texts. They're building some marketing initiatives. Redtail is doing super cool stuff with compliant text messaging. And so it's not something that's restricted just to marketing tech. You're finding that a lot of companies are focused on how do we help advisors become better communicators? And you're seeing that throughout the whole industry right now.
And I feel like we're seeing a big shift to advisors really focusing on making sure that their messaging is cohesive because their clients want to be able to access them however they want, whenever they want. So whether that's social, through a mobile app, through their website, whatever that medium may be, they need to make sure that they have that cohesive experience. So what are you seeing there?
Totally. So advisors have to think, how's my communication style the same no matter where I am? So on social, on their blog, if they're running any sort of ads, you know, if they're on the radio, lots of advisors have radio shows, but no matter where you communicate with someone, you have to be authentic, which just means that you're the same person no matter where you are in any sort of situation. Your voice should be the same. If you're a more humorous, lighthearted person, then your social accounts should present that to people. You shouldn't just be this stuffy, very super professional sort of person. Embrace who you are. If you want to be weird, be weird.
So last question. Obviously, tons of new emerging tech in this space. Mm-hmm. A lot of trends we should be focusing on. Yeah. Where is your head right now with everything?
So the emerging tech is fascinating. There are a lot of new challengers to some really well-established incumbents in many different areas. You've seen a couple of portfolio management technology companies enter the fray. Recently, there's new sort of AI-based financial planning, and I think more competition is always good. The thing I'm most excited about is to see how those new companies push the existing well-established players to keep innovating, because we can use the word innovation so often, doesn't always mean a ton, and the best way to keep innovating is to have someone nipping at your heels and pushing you to be better. So I'm really excited to see those new companies and how they challenge the ones we know and love already.
Absolutely. Well, I will certainly be watching those trends with you. So Johnny, thank you so much for your insights today.
Thank you, Shannon. I love doing this with you.
Likewise. From Medici Studio, I'm Shannon Rosick.